Eric show. Let's see. It's only me and I'm in the wilderness. I'm not actually in the wilderness. I'm in Hemlingby Natural Reserve area. It's just outside of Gävle, and for some reason I decided to do this in English. So this is a test. So after 42k, I decided to take a rest. I was so exhausted and tired. 11,000 meters of altitude and 45 degrees. My god, it's so hot. No water, no shade. And there's still 52 kilometers to go. Straight from ultra super duper train, Hemlingby. Now I need to take a rest. Yeah. My god, I just found the most intense shortcut in this train. It goes straight through the woods and it's awesome. Man, people die for this opportunity. Follow me and I would maybe there is Bear Grylls over there. Yeah. Back to give it a physical lesson, you see, it's good. So running, it's basically about knees. So I have one knee, I have this knee, it's a good knee. I have another knee, it's this knee, it's also a good knee, because you use them when you run. There are joints, you see, it's very important. This is a piece of northern Swedish Norwegian wood. It's excellent for making up fires. So if you get stuck somewhere in the middle of the night, for instance, during the Hemlingby Ultra Dunder Super Trail Run, you can use this. But do not eat it, it's poisonous. But you can bring it with you. Think about it. What would Buddha do? See the trees because of all the forests. Woo-hoo! So the race was hard, tough, and I'm exhausted. It was about 160k running like the wind. I got lost 52 times. I had no idea where I was, but it was exhilarating, adrenaline, it was a rush, and I discovered many things in life. I discovered Buddha, he was a glorious person, and I discovered trees and forests, and most importantly, I discovered myself, and now I feel more in line with the solar system, and I can run forever. Thank you. I also found some garbage, which I picked up.